Hello fellow modelers and styling fanatics, welcome back to my channel. I hope that everyone is doing fine and enjoys the hobby. George from the Concrete Bunker is here once again. This time the broadcast is all about my next project and a channel shout out. Now because as always my ramble is about to start, I advise you guys to grab a seat and crack the mandatory cold one so you can handle the butchering of the English language which is coming right now. Let's start from the shout-out first. Quick disclaimer, this guy isn't aware that I am doing this shout-out for him, but he is one of the modelers that inspired me to build stuff and I have grabbed lots of his ideas and techniques. He is none other than Coins Scale Modeling. His name is Mike, he builds mostly military stuff and sci-fi. 95% of his uploads consists from awesome dioramas. His work is pristine and he has huge knowledge. I am telling you guys, you have to see his work. He doesn't upload a lot, but when he does, he has great stuff to offer. So please go and check him out. And if you are interested, give him a sub. Now let's get back to our bench. After thinking of what to do next, this is what happens if your stash consists of 6 kits, you can decide. I settled with this little guy. A Panzer kpfw 1 Ausf.b from Italeri in 1 to 35th scale and kit number 6523. Before I start with the kit info and unboxing, I would like to make a poll. So, I need you guys to vote between two options. A. Build the tank straight out of the box and do a final. Or B. Build the tank in a what if kind of funny situation I have in mind. I would love to hear what you would like to see, so let me know at the comment section below. Now, let's talk about this kit. According to ScaleMates, this kit is a 2015 Reeboks from an older Italeri kit and has some updated and some new parts added. Upon opening the box, give me a moment. We find the instruction manual, 4 sprues with link by link tracks, 2 sprues with the tank parts, 1 small piece of photo etch, and this little piece with water slide decals. Quite an amount of parts for a small tank like this, which I find to be awesome. Now you guys are going to give me some time to reposition my camera so we can have a better look at the parts. Be right back. Now I am all settled and we are ready to go. Let's start as always from the instructions first. Typical Italeri leaflet. Over here in the first page we have some information about the vehicle in various languages. Second page we have the sprue map and the color callouts for this vehicle. It's all for Italeri acrylic paint. Construction begins with, as usual, with the lower hull, road wheels and suspension system. We move along to some hatches on the upper part and on the upper hull and the vents. Third step, we have more parts of the upper hull. Fourth step is meeting of the upper hull with the lower hull. And the armor plates over here for the transmission in the front. Fifth is the bending of the photo edge part, the exhaust system assembly, and pioneer tools for the upper hull and stuff like that. More pioneer tools over here in the sixth step. Seventh step is the painting of and the assembly of the figure that is included in the box. There's only one, and here is the guy. Turret assembly. And finally the tracks. For color callouts, we have four different variants of the vehicle. First is for the 7th Panzer Division, 25th Panzer Regiment, Battalion Headquarters Company of France, 1940. Second is unknown unit during the Poland invasion, September 1939. Third, and probably the most interesting if you ask me, is an unknown unit in the Balkans in 1941. And fourth is the 7th Panzer Division in Russia, 1941. I still don't know which one I'm gonna do. For me, there are two options, because three of them are Panzer Grey and one is flat white with Panzer Grey. Anyway, I'm gonna think about that. And that's all for the instructions. Moving on to the easy parts now. It's the four sprues, the four identical sprues for the trucks. So I'm gonna leave three aside and take a look at this one. Give me a moment. So mostly I don't call them link and length. Box calls them link and length. The only length is this one over here, this part. As you can see, the parts are tracks are small for this vehicle and probably fiddly. But they have no injection pin marks, and looks that I'm gonna only be cleaning the sprue gates over here. So we're gonna see how they assemble. Four identical, as I said, from this. Next up, we have the first of the two gray sprues that contains the lower hole and the one piece of the upper hole. Crisp detail over here. We have also components of the turret and hatches and vision ports. Some pioneer tools. From a quick look, I give them, since I just unboxed and get them out of their clear parts right now. There is minimum flash, nothing too heavy, and the parts are clean and crisp, so I should face no problem. Sprue gates on every piece are small. I'm just concerned for pieces like this and this, because they are pretty fragile, but if I am careful, I will probably face no problem. That's the first of the two sprues. Second and final sprue is this one over here. This one contains rod wheels, sprocket wheels, fenders over here, our figure, and suspension system parts. Oh, I dropped this fender, so I'm gonna leave him in the box. Also here, the parts look pretty detailed despite their size. Have nice detail on the wire rope over here. I cannot remember the name in English. Please excuse me, guys. And these two things probably are the main guns. They're like cylindrical tubes and Oh, I am a bit disappointed. They should look a bit better. Anyway, we're gonna see as we assemble it. And now we made it. We've made it. To see the photo etch thread, there is only one piece. This is the cover, the exhaust cover looks thin. I'm not gonna remove it from the buggy because I don't want to damage it. It looks pretty thin, and the detail looks great. Probably you won't be able to see it through my camera because, as always, I'm using my cell phone. And finally, we have the water slide decals over here. Decals look pretty thin. We have, as I said, four markings. And they are looking in pristine condition. They are not yellowed. Probably I won't face any problem with them. And that was everything about this kit that's included in the box. Now, before I go, as always, I want to thank each and every one of you guys for watching. I also want to welcome any newcomers. I hope that all of you are enjoying my videos and what I do here. If so, you'll know what to do. Leave a like, comment with your thoughts and opinions, and this time with the poll about the vote, sorry. Share the video or even consider subscribing for more builds to come your way. Until the next time, fellow modelers and friends, take care and model on. It was that Mofo Damon signing out.